Good morning, everybody. Very good morning. I'm very happy to be here, and I'm delighted to introduce the first plenary session. And I think we start with very interesting point of views about the use of the data from a perspective, from a general perspective, if you can say in that way. And because the data, the use of the data, is possible at several levels. We are speaking about the implication for the teaching activities, but also as an infrastructure, immaterial infrastructure, to see or to observe very important phenomena about education. This is one of our main goals. We have several goals as a public institution, but I think our data can be considered as a public good in a certain sense, and is our duty. I do believe this is our duty to use this data, to make available this data for the public opinion, for politicians, stakeholders, decision makers, about the use of the data in order to improve the quality of our educational systems. And we worked a lot in order to realize, in a certain sense, a lot of things are still to do, but anyway, we worked a lot in order to make available this data for the community, starting from the scientific community, universities, other research entities like National Statistical Bureau or other entities or bodies, not only in Italy. And I'm very happy, even proud, to be here and to thank my colleagues of our statistical department, because they made possible to be here after, I think, more or less 10 years, maybe a little bit more, of very, very hard work on that, in this direction. And going to our keynoters, I'm proud and I'm delighted to introduce Professor Giorgio Vittadini. I don't think he needs so many presentation or introduction, because he's very well known at country level, but also at international levels. He's a statistician. We are very proud because we also are statisticians. Patrizia is a statistician. It's quite easy to understand because the use of the data, even in an introduction. And Professor Vittadini will show us the use of the data as infrastructure and the implication of that, not only for the policy, but also for the research. Because as the president of ISTAT, our national bureau of statistics, not the former president, of course we are doing a specific kind of research. Of course, there is a lot of methodological implications in our activities, but the specificity, the peculiarity of our research is to make available the data and the methods for policies. And in this sense, I think the data, our data, our data, are a good tool where we can implement the sample surveys in a national structure of data, using that in order to give to all the stakeholders information and to take also decision with evidence-based approach that is extremely important, especially in our country that is I cannot say unusual, but not so common sometimes. So, going immediately to the professor Giorgio Vittadini, and we have more or less 45 minutes for the keynote, and then we have more or less 15 minutes for questions or your suggestions, but we will say after. Thank you again, and Giorgio, you can find your presentation here.
My talk is about administrative survey data for studying on monitoring and quality skills. I think it's a testimony of possible use of invasive data and also a methodological testimony, because you can start from my paper to see that invasive data the title is Administrative and Survey Data for Study Non-Cognitive and Cognitive Skills. I was saying that this is a testimony of possible use of invasive data for the research. It's also a methodological testimony, because you can start from my speech to see that invalsi is not only a very important way of evaluation of Italian student preparation, but also a possible infrastructure for research. Therefore, as you see, the issue is non-cognitive and cognitive skills. What does it mean? That you know that the human capital is a very important point of the research about education. Human capital can be defined as skills and abilities acquired through investment in education, where returns are identified by higher individual expected earnings. Becker and the Chicago School in 1960 studied it. Becker won a prize about it, but after 20 years speaking about human capital, the new concept is cognitive skills. That means innate and acquired abilities and competencies, usually measured with body form achievement tests, most recent decades. What does it mean? That you use the test school, test invalsi test, to measure human capital, not only after the school, as in the Chicago School, but during the school career of students. With this kind of evaluation, that are international evaluation, but like invalsi, we have in many, many countries this kind of evaluation. You think about the PISA, about international evaluation of young people, 15 young people, many other data set about it. But then, since 1990, above all, another Nobel Prize, Ekman, Jeff Ekman, began to study the non-cognitive skills, personal traits, the potential effect, goal-directed judgment, problem-solving students and worker, cognitive skill performance. And now I will define non-cognitive skills, because non-cognitive skills are another way of defining human capital. And we can see that non-cognitive skills can be inputs, resources of production process, education production process, and cognitive skills are the results. So we have two research questions: how to study and to measure the ability to transform students' non-cognitive skills in cognitive skills given other control variables, and how to verify if educational intervention can improve non-cognitive skills. But first of all, we define non-cognitive skills, starting from a very known group of non-cognitive skills, that are the Big Five. And you immediately see what does it mean non-cognitive skills. There are different way of looking at intelligence, not measuring performance, but think, for example, extraversion, dynamism, or agreeableness, that means friendliness, empathy, or conscientiousness, scrupulosity, perseverance, neuroticism, that means emotional stability, or openness to experience, culture, to experience, to reality. This kind of concepts were considered outside knowledge, character of young people, very important to look at young people and students, were not connected with knowledge. James Ekman began to study them as a very important factor of knowledge, because he began to study achievement test in the US, saying if you only measure cognitive skills by achievement test and you don't consider this kind of cognitive skills, you cannot understand knowledge in the complete overview. So it's very important to see the links. And but I show you that non-cognitive skills are larger than the Big Five, or Big Three, that is a definition connected with Big Five. Because you can see learning orientation, that means versus personal orientation. If you study to reach performances or to increase personal abilities, if you like to study, then self-regulation or motivation to study, then motivation. And then external locus of control. If you think that you are responsible of your performances, or you think that if you are better, it depends from external effects. Then psychological capital, that means a positive way of staying in front of reality. For example, self-efficacy to execute the tasks, or optimism, of hope. There are many definitions, and it's very important that I say to you about this definition, because our research tries to take into account all these concepts. But not only, there is another definition connected with non-cognitive skills that is given by sociologists, social capital. That means interpersonal relationships, as free time activity, watching television, using computer, video games, playing with friends, helping at home, reading a book, doing a work, playing sport, courses of different kinds. It's very important to take into account, because the young people, students, are affected by this kind of using free time activities. And then also quality of teaching connected with social capital. If the teacher tries to have a challenging education, stimulating students, or a management education, traditional way of teaching. And then family characteristics. The grandfather of family, socioeconomic conditions, if the parents study or not study. All these conditions are important for defining non-cognitive skills. Given that, we can summarize in three points. What you know that is a cognitive skill. Who you are. The non-cognitive skills that define you, or who know the characteristics of activities of you and your background, family, social capital. Given that, we get to the point, which kind of data we need. And for choosing data and speaking about privacy, we have some methodological suggestion, because also in Ekman and his school papers, you can read a very important a book, the Lean Achievement Test, 2014, by University of Chicago, you see that the analysis is very tough and important, but they don't use many definitions of quality skills. They use some of big five, and in many cases, with dichotomous items. And they don't use social capital. They don't speak about background of family. It also because, and I will say that you have a lot of money in the US, but it's difficult to have administrative data that are valid for all US. You have Massachusetts survey, Pennsylvania survey, Florida survey, and so it's difficult to have data who describe all kinds of quality skills. Everyone tries to speak about a different quality skills, and in a very, very simple way. So our suggestion is if you study quality skill, you have to take into account these multidisciplinary definitions so of sociologists, of psychologists, of pedagogists, economists, and so on. And then you take into account social capital, otherwise sociologists are very, very angry with us. Second, so multidimensional and multidisciplinary overview on quality skills. First, request. Second, with respect to quantitative measure of cognitive skills, is it better to utilize indicator linked with student scholar performance? Because think about it. I have a big survey. I try to measure student performances, but it's different from usual performances for the school, for the student during the school. It's very difficult to compare this data. Because if you use different ways of judging performances, not cognitive skills, it's very difficult to compare them. Then, we need permanent data. Because these kind of studies are cross-sectional. But school is a path where you start from elementary school to get high school. It's very important to see the improvement. You remember Meloni as well. These the added values means I have to see added values about knowledge. Then, many of these studies are about family hardship situation, social marginalization, risk of dropout. It's also important to study students in a normal situation. These four requests are the methodological criteria for choosing data. Because from my statistical point of view, I think the data are chosen starting for your need. But I use this data because I use this data. The data are an answer to a methodological request. So we have two kinds of data, survey data, administered data, and then merge of this. We start from educational survey data sets. And many studies on quality skills are based on surveys, collecting selected samples through ad hoc questionnaires, study student samples at individual level, generating information on each student, his family, social background, free time, quality skill, conducted by a variety of subjects, regional state government in Italy, regions, mayor, school, public or private agencies, ISTAT, Invalsi, Alma Laurea, Foundation, Fondazione Agnelli, employers, consumer association, advocacy groups, And they can be periodic, annual, ongoing, or one time only. Both. Given that, there are some problems. First of all, I already spoke about it. Cognitive skills scores influenced by judgment of teacher are not valid for general cooperation. Or teacher or people who direct research. Because if I direct research in India and I direct research in Florida and my idea is some theory and I have another theory, how I can compare? If I have a scale from 0 to 10, my 10 is different from your 10. And so I cannot see if Indiana students are better than Florida students. Second, every survey collects particular kinds of demographic, socioeconomic, family background variables and also types of non-cognitive skills. And very difficult to compare. Above all, if I use a statistical tool, because if I don't use the same variables, also as explicative variables, it's difficult to compare. Then, they are often cross-sectional data, because I do this research, it's very difficult to go. Think about it, the research on cognitive skills of OECD, international research about work path after the school about cognitive skills, was closed, because Italy decided not to go. So, you have some data and you stop cross-sectional, and you cannot see if this change. Above all, about the same subject. Then, survey data may take a long time to collect analysis. And then, accuracy of coding is in data cannot be verified. And for a statistician, very important. In many cases, surveys do not contain linking variables, because we are statisticians, we obey privacy, but we need that after having obeyed every kind of law about privacy, we can match. Otherwise, we cannot do anything. And educational services are very expensive. In Italy, it's very difficult. Italy didn't participate to OECD, I think also for money. Private people cannot work. And then, the sample drawn from the population may not be representative for low response rates because we respond different important ways for those who don't respond. Bias, because it's not random, the choice of participating or participating. Therefore, look at educational administrative data that are generated by educational institutional providers, school, MIUR, agency, and embassy, typically computerized, and that is better because you can use that, and they can be collected by a variety of proposals. For example, embassy is for evaluation. MIUR can be for a register, annual register. But there are some limitations also for administrative data, because cognitive score and administrative data managed by teacher are not valid for comparison. Because look at this. I am a professor in Trento. You are a professor in Palermo. I give my vote. But for the school it's good because you have your way of judging, my way of judging, freedom. But then, how to compare two votes? For a university, you have some techniques for a comparison of different kinds of votes, rush methods, but it's very difficult to use to put together votes of different parts of Italy, different schools, different teacher, you need a general way of judging. Second, for the official confirmation, often this data don't contain information regarding cognitive skills, demographics, socioeconomic aspects, family background, because for administrative goals, you needed it. But for research goals, you need it. In many countries, it's difficult to have panel data for a ban and presence of national register. Also in Italy, we are speaking about national register. We have been speaking for many, many years, but until now, you don't have national register. The accuracy of calling the missing data varies substantially across schools and regions because it depends on employees and so on. And it could be difficult for privacy programs to link administrative data to other data files because you go to the administration and the administration says, I don't want to give my data for research. My goal is different. Or you say, yes, but 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, 2 years, and so on. And then we have lack of information on students. And if you need causal inference studies about students and those students, you cannot do this. So we need another choice. First of all, to have different kinds of administrative data. And have this different kind of administrative data that you can match with survey data. Now we have the MARDER, convulsive data sets, at this point of the representation. Because I have the honor with Keki and Kino in 2008. To propose the invasive measurement system. We are speaking with Roberto 11 years ago, with Cipollone, who was president. And after having said what I was saying, you can see that this invasive measurement system overcomes many problems of other administrative and educational data sets. First of all, they are based on standardized achievement tests for mathematics, Italian, language, problem solving. And so you can compare, because everywhere, in all our country, you have the same method, and the assessors who are not teachers of the school. They are outside the school. And I know that this is very, very tough for many people in the school. But for research is better, because I can say that one scope, standardized scope of in Basel, in Milan, in Rome, in Catania, are the same way of judging. Second, is the only data set concerning cognitive skills, socioeconomic and democratic variables, family school background, all the students. Because these data are very, very rich. Not only the usual administrative data set, name, surname, birth. No, you have many, many very important variables. And in 2005, for the first time in Italy, from the administrative organization, a research about non-cognitive skills. We, for building our questionnaire, we started from this non-cognitive skill survey of 2015 of IBAS. Then, the IBAS tests are administered to students of the second grade, fifth grade of primary school, third grade of the secondary school or middle school, the second grade and fifth grade of the high school. We have a student panel data. And then, there is very good control of data, missing data by the statisticians of Vasi, and then a cheating correction. Also cheating correction. I can take into account when a school is not so good, they try to change the results, and you know that in Italy it can happen. I speak for foreigners. If I can, I do. Different way from Obama. And we can match Vasi data sets with other data sets by means anonymous identifiers. Therefore, our proposal is a matching of Invasi data set with a non-quantitative service. We started from the Invasi data set and we integrated them with promise of training to data set students at the 5th grade of elementary school and the 3rd grade of middle school. We match Invalsi and PAT administrative dataset with PAT service. We use integrated student panel data. We measure non-cognitive skill according to a multidimensional theory. We identify cognitive skill with scores related to Invalsi national standardized test. We study students in conditional normality. We see that all the methodological requests are answered, starting from Invalsi dataset. We in the prominent trends of there are 77 middle schools and 25 middle schools freely participated to research and project. So a good example because of 1,100 students on 5,500 students. So the data set is Invalsi May 2011. 5th grade elementary, where we have cognitive student quantitative scores in Italian math in elementary school, social capital variables and control variables. Then the same for the 3rd grade in the school. Then a PAT survey on non-cognitive skills, where we collect non-cognitive skills, starting from items, with Fraccaroli Pisani, Fraccaroli full professor in psychology in the University of Trento, and PAT administrative data about control variables. So we have this kind of data set with cognitive skills scores, control variable, we will see this control variable, non-cognitive skills 2018 variables, that we collected, but connected, we will see, with Invalsi 2015 Latin variable, that social capital variable. And we see that our choices with different names are similar to choices of Invalsi 2015. We started for your items to build our items, to have a methodological way of building this non-cognitive skill that can be accepted. You were naming Darling Elfted, relational stability, or anxiety, neuroticism, Italian self-concept, self-efficacy, performance or station, the same, or external software study, quality competition, and so on. And SCS indicator that is better than ISF indicator of professional training. But our idea is to repeat similar choices. It is very rich, richer than international research of OECD or ECMAN. After that, methodology, first of all, we verified if the sample is random, because the schools freely accept, but these students' educational attainment affect the decision to join the research. That means the good schools accepted, the bad school no. Second, we build national non-cognitive skills latent variable with factor analysis starting from items as Invalsi did in 2015. Then, multilevel model, I summarize it, the response variable are the cognitive scores, and the explicative variable are non-cognitive skills, control variables, and then you verify if there is a part of it explained by different schools. That means J means that the different school affected the result or not. And we have this index EICC, variance explained by schools. If is little, we needed a multi-level model. But we started from multi-level model because from the methodological point of view, if you have hierarchical data, students and school, you have to start from this kind of analysis. Then, if this analysis is useless, you can pass to a linear model. The first result is that the sample is random, because the t-test rejected the hypothesis that the means of the group are different. Group participating or participating to the research. It means that the school who participated participated not because they are the best schools in training. Then we saw that there are problems of normality. We transform the Valsi score to the variable z equal 1 given y square. That is one of the possible transformation for obtaining normality, and the only change that the smaller are the coefficients, the stronger covariance are positively related with z. Third, we needed a multi-level model because the part explained by the school is minus than 1%, and so we choose linear models, and I said it for statistician, we choose a feasible general least square linear model to avoid problem on non-sparsity random error. So we have the result, but the result show us that the part explained is 40-49, that is good. Then that the residual are normal. And now I give you the meaning of the result. Then we don't have outliers. First of all, in Valsi, fifth grade primary school are clear positive link with third grade middle schools. And is something that already Ekman suggested. When you are good in a primary school, you can be good in middle and high school. Because these studies about human capital demonstrated that primary school are very, very important. The major part of your cognitive skill are obtained in the primary school. Because in these years, students are very, very able to know. Second, and this is the main result. Some cognitive skills like instability, scholar motivation, and self-efficacy are positive relation with cognitive skill. It's demonstrated. Not every cognitive skill, non-cognitive skill, but non-cognitive skill related with studied personality, studied character, improve their knowledge. And third, in negative way, performance orientation, external locus of control are negative relation with cognitive skill. It's very important because these two non-cognitive skills describe a lack of responsibility. So, responsibility, better cognitive skills. And the lack of responsibility, worsen student cognitive skills. That means the best character, this is the last definition of Ekman about non-cognitive skills. In the last book, he names non-cognitive skills character skills. The character school are important for cognitive skills. If you have the similar IQ, but you have this kind of character or responsibility, you can know more and more. And this is very important because the first time that we did this in Italy, in the school of Italy, raised to Valsi data. Then challenge education and positive link with cognitive skills, while management education are negative links with cognitive skills. That means that very important if you want to study for learning. For if you want to study learning, you can know more and more. Then important also to see the social capital results. Some of them excess of video games, playing with friends, time given a talk without doing anything, worsen the cognitive skill, tend to distract them. Others do homework, playing sport, and hence they cognitive skill stimulates them. So also your kind of living is very important. And then, and this is very important for verifying that our result is good, parents, higher educational family, better socioeconomic condition, improve cognitive skill. That means that you know that in Italian school, Parentino school, inequalities are not completely filled by the education system. We already know, but it's important to verify it. So the first racial question had a good answer. But I want to stress that this is connected with your data. For this reason, I think it's very important in this session, that without invasion, it was impossible to do this. Because you can say, but you verify, you judge in different way. Second part, matching. To verify if educational intervention can improve cognitive skills. Because many researchers at Ekman said that non-cognitive skills are malleable and that appropriate educational program improve them. It's very important because in the literature people said, but okay, non-cognitive skills, but like IQ, you have your cognitive skills, non-cognitive skills, and stop. You cannot change. No. And for verifying it, helped by Professor Trento, we verify that some of the schools are doing program for improving of quality skills. It's very important. There is a very big confusion about quality skills in school, Italian school. Miur says you have to do, but no one knows everything. But many schools began to do this. We verify that in Trentino school there are 188 programs to improve cognitive in some schools. So for us statisticians it's good. Some schools do this, some other schools don't do this. Match. If the schools who use non-cognitive skill treatments are better than the schools that don't use it. We build a matching treatment. 12 schools manage non-cognitive project on 25 schools who participated to the research, and 13 schools did not. And we have two group of programs. Programs on cognitive connected to the educational part, or program related to the student character. We divided the school in the first group of 12 schools and then the other group of 30 schools, and we proposed a propensity score matched analysis where, in this case, non-cognitive skills are response variables. We have some school with treatment, other school without treatment, and 10 covariates capturing student characteristics, gender, full-time school, enrollment, kindergarten, type of higher school, children, school in Valle dell'Agri, in other schools, and the 10 results in this case, cognitive skills are covariates, and 10 socioeconomic indices, data, control variables. These are the results. Three non-cognitive skills are improved by schools who use treatment. Relational stability, self-efficacy, and optimism. Instead, they are linked, positively linked with two cognitive skills. Instead, neuroticism, that is emotional stability is negative, are negatively linked with cognitive skills, and they decrease with the treatment. Therefore, both educational projects focus on improving students' character and educational part, as a result, we demonstrated that the educational projects already managed by the schools can improve non-cognitive skills. The second answer. So, we are concluding time. Conclusion. We verify the invasion with the data integrated with the survey regarding non-cognitive skills allowed to analyze the links between non-cognitive and cognitive skills. And we demonstrated that there are these links. Non-cognitive skills are important for improving cognitive skills. Then, second, opportunity and educational treatment improve non-cognitive skills, improve student characters. So we can do this. And this, so our result is very important for two points. Fourth, research, because this is the first research, but we have to study students in their path also after that, with the school, to see if in all their path, non-cognitive skills improve, not more and more after the middle school, in high school. And using also different kind of tools or statistical tools, and different, because the first result is the empirical result with linear model. The second result that is matching is a causal result. We want to improve our research using causal tools also in the first part. But for this, we need more times, and we want to do this. Second, I saw the title of this meeting, Research and Education. If it's true that educational treatment towards the improvement of cognitive skills can improve them, we have another scenario in our school. We can use also other way of teaching, without destroying the way of teaching for improving quality skills, but also using treatment for improving his character. That means something that the teacher knows. So many teachers understand that it's important for them is not only to verify quality skills. If you give a bad score at the beginning of the year, before the second test, you already understand if your students are improved, if they are active, if they are alive, if they are interested. We can do this in a systematic way. And so it's important that Muir is suggesting it, but it's also important to teach the teachers to do this. How we can valorize it. And you see that in this case, in Valsi, data set allow us to improve our educational project in our school. Thank you.
Thank you
very much. It's a very interesting presentation, a lot of things to think about. And I really appreciate your approach and how you to show us how is important a multidisciplinary approach to this kind of issues that are crucial. And I think it's a very clear way to understand how it's important to have data, to measure things that we already know, but we need measure about the entity, about the size of the effects. Of course, we open several fields of research and of debate as well, because we are introducing so many different aspects with so many implications in our course, in our way to educate, in our way to do schools every day. But I think it's very, very important to start also in this way to see how to consider, how to change things that we know are so important for our future of our schools. So I would like to open the floor, and I would ask you to come here and to pose your questions if you want, if it's possible to do that in English, and otherwise we can translate it in English for our friends. And so please don't be shy, and feel free to ask or to your question or your remarks. And I would please come in. May I ask you to introduce yourself?
Good morning. I'm Lorenzo Maraviglia from the province of Pisa. I have two technical questions. First one is how did you address the issue of possible selection of students into school based on the treatment? I mean, families or students who are interested in certain projects may select a school based on the fact that that project is available. So I understood it was made through matching, but maybe there are some unmatchable variables because they are not measured and they are not available. Latent variables which could influence the result. So, which could be related to the treatment. And I would like to go, if you can go deeper on this point. The second point is if you considered the possibility of using varying slopes, not only varying intercepts. Well, you told us that intercept, there was not variability at this level. But however, I would like to have your answer on this point.
The first question is very interesting because Damiano Previtali, one of the employees of the minister, began to do this research. And the schools were to do this. The schools, the students and the teacher didn't understand that they were doing treatment for non-cognitive skills. There is not, when you enroll your student to the school, there is not evidence that you are doing a treatment. Studying the school, Damiano and discovered that some programs were connected to cognitive skills, but no one could know this in advance. So no one could choose schools for that. And therefore, for this reason, we think that the subsample about treated and untreated is not it is random, because it's the first time that someone described this kind of treatment, because in schools many teachers understand that it's not enough to teach as they were saying before. But many of them don't understand that connected with the cognitive skills. They understand that it's important to improve some characteristics of students. But this situation, that is a general situation, is a situation where if you don't teach teacher, don't speak them about non-cognitive skills, they do something without understanding. When we had a lot of meetings with teachers, they didn't know non-cognitive skills. They asked, what about it when the mules speak about it? I don't understand. But they were doing it. Therefore, for the research, for this reason, we say that no one chose the school for that. But this is another lack. The lack is that we cannot go on in our school suggesting words without helping people to understand that these words are a very important, a big importance for improving the results. So, for the research. About the second, no, but I think it's a very important suggestion, because Roberto knows we finished 2 months ago this study, and this is the first presentation, and we have to improve the result, but I think very important. But I think that the question that is an ethological question is important also for saying, starting from embassy, please, suggesting something new, can you explain this is something new? Because I at the beginning I explained you non-pathologist inventory, I think that many people don't know this. Without doing this, I knew Big Five starting from Ekman. But I couldn't think that motivation is a part of non-pathology skills. But everyone understands that your students can improve the result if they are motivated. But you have to understand that this is connected with the most important literature about school now.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Any
other questions? Staff Daniele Vigioni, the European Commission.
Daniele Vigioni, European Commission. Thank you, Giorgio. It's very interesting. I just wanted to ask one question concerning teachers. Did you have information about teachers? Did you have some kind of because this is one of the issues. I mean, in school, we don't have information about teacher characteristics and teaching strategies. Were you able to collect any type of information on this topic?
Thank you.
Until now, it's not a lack. We don't have information for a single reason. That now. Atareti, having spoken with them, presented the research, now we can speak with them. But at the beginning, it was enough to have information about school. Because you know that at the beginning, if you ask a teacher about some of their characteristics, they say, you are destroying my freedom. So I think that is very important information. But I am a statistician, first of all, I am a man. Human being, and I understand that if you want to go on your research, you have to convince people that you are not doing something against it. Many educational research in school didn't get the result because you are against teachers and then families. You are a researcher. You are a researcher. Now I think we can collect this kind of information because teachers understand that you are working with them, for them. And so, but for this reason, I repeat that you have to start from data that you already collect. Think about if in 2008 or before, the Invalsi couldn't build his system. You couldn't speak it neither of teacher, neither of student. After 11 years with a lot of fights, you can defend this result. So your question is, have to me to say, if you want to research schools, you cannot walk as an elephant. I am a scientist. Oh, you have to work with people that you are studying.
This is a very, very important another question, please.
I am a new director of school. And in Turin. And my school is Leonardo da Vinci and is one of the school where there are a lot of problems. And I agree with the idea that the teachers need an improvement of their understanding of which are not cognitive skills, or cognitive skills to improve their strategies. But my question is this. I found a school where treatment of not cognitive skills are a lot, but are with external programs in the afternoon with other association who take care of this aspect. I think that we need to build a stronger link between the curriculum and the daily didactic aspects and the treatment of non-cognitive skills. What do you think about it? Because I find a big difference. Teachers use traditional methods in the morning and some other educators come in the morning, only in the afternoon, and they use different ways of teaching and or to play with students. I think that this is not good to improve cognitive skills, but we need more relation, more link between these two aspects. And I try to introduce this idea, but it's not very easy. What do you think about this?
I wrote this link to student-scholar performance. When I was saying this, if we have to explain to improve performance, this is in the daily situation. Because external situation, first of all, when you have external problem, many teachers are angry. Because they say, I already work. Please speak with me. Without this link is something that can be far from my initiative, far from my desire that I am in contact with students, I know them. Otherwise, it's a specialization. First of all, this for second, for the students, the importance is the contact with the teachers. The teachers are more able to give results because non-cognitive skills are connected with way of doing. A treatment, if is outside the encounter of the teacher with the students, it becomes a mechanism. I think that in Italy, I think one of the most important contributions of European research, European pedagogy, respect to American pedagogy and research, is to understand that cognitive skills are characters, not mechanics. Not mechanic traits, because otherwise you don't understand that this non-cognitive skills are observed traits or something that is a Latin value, character. The character is connected with teachers. Because during your lesson, when you say, look at you, what do you say? Why do does your face is ugly? This is a cognitive skill treatment, not organized. Because when a student who is unhappy speaks with the teacher, this improves his motivation. For this reason, I agree with you, even this reason.
Thank you very much. Do you have other questions or remarks or suggestions? So, thank you very much. I think I really grateful to you, Giorgio, to join us, to give us this very interesting presentation and to open to us so many things to do and to think about. And I think at least we have to work about a common vocabulary. Because there are so many disciplines involved in this issue that we have to share also a vocabulary to understand clearly what we are doing. So thank you very much.